Can I really assume that we know a bit of agile software development lifecycle and product engineering?
Yes.
Yes, something else. Okay, so I don't really delve deep into these concepts. Rather than we will try to give you certain pragmatic approaches and our collective experiences. When I say that, maybe certain best practices which we came across, and at the same time, not only them, but also the lessons learned, right? So let's see how it crops up as well. And a brief introduction about ourselves. So I take a step back. So from a pairing concept, you might be aware that we have got a pilot and a co-pilot. These are the two roles usually this concept has got. So for now, I will be the pilot. I will be walking through this session for some time, and Raman will be the co-pilot. Basically, the technical definitions we'll see a little bit later, but the conceptual definitions are like the pilot will run the show in the this session, and the co-pilot analyzes and gives the feedback to the pilot as well. And it's important that they switch these roles time by time as well. All right. So this is exactly what we try to do and demonstrate. Okay. So coming back to our introduction, myself, I'm Krishna, and professionally I work with Harman International. I head the quality department for engineering quality for India, and I've got around 15 years of experience. And at the same time, we follow certain agile in our product engineering company. I would say we are still a long way to go, but yes, we are trying to embrace the agile as well. From volunteering side, I'm a volunteer for PMA family chapter for the last 5.5 years. So I'll introduce my co-pilot as well for today's session, Ms. Rama. She has got around 12 years of experience, and she works for a company by name Advance as a senior QA manager. And she's also a volunteer with PMA Bangalore chapter for 2.5 years. She's an agile coach, as well as growing the agile for probably 7 to 8 years, 7 years plus. So I think with this brief introduction, let's go and see how these pairing concepts work together. So as I said, we initially we try to go through this testing challenges. So usually agile by characteristic is a time box testing. So time is the most important or critical factor from an agile aspect. So at the same time, agile also brings in the faster pace of development, which gives the QA of testing testers quite amount of challenge in terms of coping with the time what is left over, you know, to develop the test scripts or the functionality changes. Then agile also has a principle of welcoming the changes a little bit later as well. So with this, the biggest challenge is how to understand this change, what has been changed, and how to cope up with these test scripts and test cases, and how to really have the quality of the test really improved for that particular iteration or sprint. Haven't we heard this, you know, development spillovers? So this is a very common complaint we have got, where we, or rather I would say we, I myself was a developer some time back, so development team overcommits most of the times. Here I'm not hurting the ego of a developer, but it's just a general...
No, but that happens only for first 1 or 3 iterations. Post that it gets stabilized.
Yeah, correct. But I think we sometimes burn the hands too much.
True.
Right?
No, but it gives you a flexibility, right? Pushing back to the product backlog.
It does. I do agree, but certain times it's very challenging as well. Right? So because of that, the time which is left for the testers is very, very minimal. Okay, so developers again, or the engineering teams, thinks that you know, testing is the tester's job, it's not my job, so what they are for here. Okay, there is a bit of a last year as well, which is again one more challenge. Then the risk of regression. So for each and every iteration, there is a lot of functionality code implemented for that particular product, and this will really give us a very less time, and the quality of regression sometimes goes for a toss. So with all these, with the backdrop and the context, what I'm trying to say is that the time available for testing is limited, and we can't complain about it every time, but it's very important for us to use the time very efficiently and effectively, right? So how do we do that? So the power of two, you know, this is exactly what we do in real life as well. Yeah, you have a question? It's applicable in both the scenarios as well. It's applicable in both the scenarios, even within the same team or as external testing team as well.
Sure. In Agile team, there is more roles, right? All other cross-functional, and see how the testing team creating, like this limited time mode, right? How this.
So what we're trying to say is that with that kind of a challenge is what we showed, you know, before. The code that is developed or the functionality that is developed for that particular product, we need to do certain or a minimal amount of testing. And usually the time taken by the developers is so much that the time given for testing is so
much.
So
it's more road, like the Scrum as Agile, each person, same person can do multiple roles.
Yeah.
Either QA or development done by single person.
Correct.
There is no separately role for the QA or the developer.
Here we're not talking about the role, but
general
testing.
Okay.
Testing. You're absolutely right, no doubt about that. Okay, the power of two. We all use this in our real life as well. If you're married, then you're a pair, and then the wife is the boss at home. Am I right?
No.
That's what the ladies can say that. Yes. And we have to oblige. So it's a well-known proverb that two hands are better than one. And even from our cultural aspect, you know, this pairing is quite old. So if you take certain examples of Krishna and Arjuna, you know, going for the battle of Mahabharata. And then this is a very interesting thing. Even the Bible says, literally, if you can really search for this one, it says that two are better than one because they have a good return of their work. And it also says that if one falls down, I know it's very easy for the other to help. But if only one person is there, I think it's very difficult for them to really go to help if there's an issue with that person. Right. So this is exactly from our cultural aspect. When we hold our pair of hands and say this way, this is exactly the way we greet. But nowadays, we are more agile. So we say hello, hi, namaste, only with one hand. Okay, so that's exactly we have become more agile, right? But that's our culture, the way we used to you know, greet each other. So if you also see, you know, if you want to clap, you can't do it with one hand, right? Unless you have a support of a bench or something, or you know, you can make some noise. Otherwise, you use two hands. So this is exactly what we have seen. And what exactly is this technique? So I already said that. It has got certain rules, and from a pair testing concept, it's testing an application on the same computer by continuously exchanging the ideas, right? At the same time, we have got two roles, the pilot and the co-pilot. The pilot is in charge of the keyboard and the mouse, who will be responsible to perform the actual testing tasks. And the co-pilot actually analyzes, reviews, and guides the pilot. So the two members involved could take turns from a pilot and co-pilot. You want to add something here, Dama?
I have a question.
Yeah, sure.
See, how does it differ from the pair programming? We say for pair programming, right?
Yeah. I can answer this. It's like this technique is like we have, when we were practicing in our organization, from XP, we know that there is a concept called pair programming. From that only we have drawn this pair testing. So it's like two testers working together.
Okay.
it's drawn from that concept, XP programming and pair programming.
Maybe some of your questions could be auto-answered as we traverse through this presentation. If you can just hold on your horses for a moment, we just go through the actually some of the nice things here. So, okay. So I will change the role from a pilot to co-pilot mode. Rama, over to you.
Okay, how to apply this pair testing? We'll do this by activity. I want 3 volunteers.
We have some goodies as well, please.
Yes. Volunteers?
Okay, since nobody's getting up, let me start with mine.
That's good. One will be alone, team A. And two in pair, team B.
Sorry.
One will be alone as team
B. Okay, of three.
Okay. And two has to be as a team B. Okay.
Now is it balloons?
Wow. Yes. Or maybe you can draw. That's okay. And as manage yourself.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. The activity duration is 3 minutes.
How many balloons are 3?
We will see. I mean,
but you have to comment how many you can do it. Okay.
Okay.
Wow.
Somebody
to tie the knot, because I can't tie the knot.
So we have a limited resources. We have only one bundle of thread.
Yes.
Okay, so you have to use this. You have to blow the balloons, tie it, and maybe write your name on that. Or team A or team B. So team B is typically, you can name it if you want your team team A.
Team A and
person.
Team B.
Team B.
Duration is 3 minutes. Can you tie it?
Yes,
so can
I
you keep it handy? So the
yes.
Oh, wow.
And the scope is to blow the balloon, tie the thread, and write your name on it.
How big or how small?
Any? Not the thread also can be useful. Should necessarily use the thread.
Yeah.
Can be better.
Okay, I just want to know, you have to establish a goal, which has to be measurable. So in 3 minutes, how many you can blow and do all that things?
Yes, I'll try for 10.
10. Yourself? 2
you
others.
Try to double.
20 for 10 and you are doing for 20. And you have to identify who is your pilot and co-pilot. That roles you have to identify.
So maybe know your name. Nagaraj. And
Prabhakar.
So Nagaraj and Prabhakar are team B. And your name?
Anu.
So Anu is the lone horse here. So please let me know when you're ready so that we can start the game.
I'm getting my homework done. So that's 6 minutes.
And meanwhile, I'll say like you have to execute this in these 3 minutes and you have to stick to the scope. Scope is like blow the balloon, tie the thread, and write any name on it.
So there was a question from the audience that how big the balloon has to be. We'll say it's a medium size. Now we don't go into the quantitative analysis.
No.
But it is not too small, but it's sizable.
Right. Okay, currently we are at sprint 0 or iteration 0. So let me know.
It starts now.
Yes, that even is over.
Please clap for the team.
Steps are blow the balloon, tie the thread, and write any name on the balloon. I see only letters on the balloon.
That sounds okay.
I'm team A. I'm ready team A.
Okay.
But there are chances of high risk that balloon will blow.
Now it is
already
blowing.
The purple one is gone.
Okay. The purple one is gone.
Don't
the bug.
Thank you.
Very well focused.
We are half done time with the time.
Half and done.
You just had coffee.
And you can change the name on the next year.
No, I recognize my name.
The last minute.
1 minute to go.
It's just blowing off.
No spillover.
Last 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Stop.
That's over. Let's come. Okay, so you can come.
Yes,
so three
one.
Of them went bad.
Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
So I think ladies have done a better job. But still, you could manage, like, you know, doing more number of the work or task, whatever. You share your responsibilities and you're done, right? So in pair, always it is better. That is what we wanted to demonstrate, saying that always do it in pair if possible.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Anu,
oh, thank you.
A big round of applause, please.
Thank you, Nagaraj.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I was assuming they'll get the books.
Give them books?
Yeah.
They can. Then there's another competition as well.
I think you started by saying assuming. It's an assumption.
It's not a defined scope.
Yeah. Sure.
Thank you. So this is how to apply pairing. This is not only for testing, you can apply this anywhere in all the disciplines. It's like dev, QA, or you know, it's like designing team, or the analysis team, or something like QA. Usually they will keep it away, right? So it has to be a cross-functional team, and they all have to work together. So you pair manager, team leads that way. So it works very well. You try it out in your work.
No, this may work well. Post that is a dangerous thing. They'll say, give me not chocolate.
Okay.
Give me something beyond 200 rupees, then I'll do all that.
This count price, see, 1% effort is more than 2% price.
Yes, yes. We have actually...
Number of.
Yes.
Can I add a point?
Yeah.
Because this I already implemented 3 months back. We got some good success.
Yes. Actually, we have implemented in 3-4 projects which were working fine. Okay, it is like PA plus tester can work together, PA and dev can work together, so they can give the quality product.
Okay. Sorry, I came late, but how different is it from your 3 amigos that you are going to have?
Which one?
How different is it from the linear approach that you follow, the 3 amigos that you do?
I didn't get your question.
Is this from PMA perspective?
Okay.
Not from the Scrum
Alliance. Not from
Okay.
So they have come up with the innovative idea and say in line with pair programming, pair testing.
Pair testing.
So it's for different innovation.
Okay. But you can apply this pairing for all the disciplines, cross functional.
So when you're talking about pairing, you're talking about only at the stage of testing, or you're talking about together through and through?
This activity is everywhere. Okay, but other than we started with pair testing.
Okay, so
concept can be applied everywhere.
Excuse me,
for the
HI.
It can be. Yes, if you have that. If you have all the cost, yes.
I have an answer for you. I have a very interesting slide, the last slide for you. I will not reveal the secret.
That says thank you.
I'll park it. No, absolutely not. I have a very interesting slide for you.
So, overall,
that's cute.
It is the same thing, like determine the duration of the testing or any activity. Identify the scope of the work. Then establish a measurable role. Then determine who will be the pilot and co-pilot. Execute the work. And stick to the scope. So, just apply the KISS principle. Keep it very simple and stupid. Don't overcomplicate for any of these things. And the advantages of the pair testing. So, this pair testing, right now I'm talking about the QA activities. So for that QA activities, there are some advantages like better knowledge. Better knowledge is like when you're pairing two heads working together, you can get the better knowledge and functional misunderstanding won't be there among the team members. So work will be quick and test cases will be very good. No need to redo things. And inherent test case reviews. Here, if two testers are working together, two resources are working together, they no need to review, peer review their test cases. Not only test cases, any activity, no need to peer review.
But then review still is expected, right?
It is expected, but if they are working together on one system,
then no need.
It is like one reviewing only, and one working only. Based on the consensus only, we'll document the test case. Or any activity.
Time for output becomes faster.
Yes, absolutely.
And high creativity. It's like if you apply brainstorming technique, over there like you can get more ideas. Ideas can be generated and from there high creativity will be there. And increased productivity. When two are working together, it's like nobody, most of the times, no one will interrupt them. If it is one, you can work on other activities also. You can, like, you know, interruptions can be there. If two are working on the same system, they don't just, like, you know,
you
they don't
WhatsApp.
Google or something else.
In WhatsApp.
They'll be very focused to work if it is in pairs.
Yeah, but one question I want to understand is it something that you are doing a bottom-up, as in from team upwards, or is coming from down? I mean, acceptance of this is also an issue, right?
Yes.
From
it is.
From an organization perspective, one resource is sitting idle.
Yeah, the disadvantages are also there, but you have to educate the management as well when you are applying this technique.
Okay.
We also have a colleague here who has applied for, we can share his thoughts with you later as well.
Yes, sure. You can share your experience. And improved testing methodology. So if I'm working on project A and I have moved to project B, so I can share my experiences to project B member whom I pair with. So I can improve the testing methodology whatever I apply on that project. And time saving. It's like I no need to review my test cases because we two are working together. I don't think we spend time on reviewing test cases, on designing test cases, or executing test cases. It is like test cases, it's not only test cases, any task you pick up. If you are in pair, one will always analyze, give ideas, generate ideas, and you will exchange your thoughts. Better bug reporting, because you both will sit together and you report it like, you know, once you are consensus with that, okay, this is the bug, it has to be logged, so that developers also won't come to you saying that this is not a bug or whatever steps you write. It will be very proper way because two minds are together. And effective training technique. It's like, you know, separate functional training is not required to be given to that other person. So it is training in itself, on the job training. And better coordination. It's like that ego feeling and all won't be there. Like when you pair, you work and collaborate well with the other team members. So better collaboration and better reproduction of bugs. You can replicate any tricky bugs when you are working together and when you as a testers, like if you want to replicate any bug, any tricky bug, then you can do that. It's true. And disadvantages are there. When the system is not very complicated, then this is a disadvantage. And when you have very less test cases to execute, it is a disadvantage. So don't apply in this scenario, this pairing. And you have completely automated. If the testing process is completely automated, then this pairing will not work. And if my application, it requires something else, like background, some work is there, and two persons may not be required to work on the same system, they have to wait for hours, then this technique will not be applicable. And issues of documentation is compressed and pairing. This pair testing, when it stops, you have to see that it is well documented. If it is not well documented and if pair testing stops, then the new joinee, whoever is new joinee to that project, will suffer. Not only new joinee, like nobody knows like what they are working on. So pairing, these are the disadvantages for the pairing. And negative cost, like if for the same activity two members has to be there, two times the cost, so this can be a disadvantage. So here you have to see whether it is working well or not with pairing.
It's a cost benefit analysis that we don't really see.
Yeah, you can apply this on one or two projects and then you can take it over to other projects. So what do you?
Rama,
We've been, remember correctly, this is a pair testing in Agile, right?
Yes.
And when we do Agile, like he rightly said, everybody is doing a
cross-function,
right?
Yes.
So when you talk about any two people pairing,
yes.
And especially in Agile where the team size is small and you have from daily to bi-daily or weekly, whatever kind of mechanics.
2 weeks.
Yeah, so yes. Even in 2 weeks iteration, but you are talking daily about it. Pair testing, will it be efficient or time saving or productive as we are expecting it to be?
It will be.
Because
it will be time saving itself.
Very, very important. These are the factors that I'm going to really say, because these things doesn't happen overnight. We need to give, we need to define the scope, and the system has to be enough complicated, and we need to have the people inclined towards doing it as well, whom we are really selecting. Can they really go well together? Do they have the right domain knowledge, right expertise to do this? Okay, and are we as a management committed? Is the scope really defined? Are we doing it in a open floor, or are we really going to the room and really doing it? And are we, from a cultural aspect as well, we go overboard sometimes, so without sticking to the scope. So these are few of the aspects which are there, which has to be taken care. These are the noise which really taken care of.
Yeah.
Can give you results. Not the first time. We need to embrace it over a period of time. And as I said, this will not be a silver bullet for the first time.
Yeah.
But we need to embrace it. We need to really, I would say, practices becomes habits and habits become attitude, right? So first, we need to do a course correction, right? And then we need to fine tune our process to suit our business needs.
Because see, typically when the traditional project we've been following is well documented, structure, well documented duty. And then on well-documented results and so on. Agile, everything is not documented.
But it has to be.
So then if it is
less documented, it has to be documented. They say it is, like weightage has to be there.
Okay.
Before I go to the next problem, request you to share your experiences. Maybe if you can come here, that would be really nice. Because if we record it for the benefit of others as well.
How did you do it? That's interesting.
Yeah. You have maybe 3 minutes.
Yeah.
You finish on time as well.
So how I implement it is, the main thing is, first, my team members, they don't have any vision. The people are coming, they are doing work, they are going. Second thing, they don't have any business knowledge. What is the application, how it is working, what are the third parties, the people are not aware. And third thing is, they don't have much interaction with the on-site team, even the DOT. So I conduct a meeting with one-on-one, I identify what is your problems, where we have to improve, what is plus and minus. Based on that, I prepared like my metrics. So I identify the people who will suit for him. So that I paid like that. And I told to my manager saying that don't expect any results within a month. I required, you know, 3 months. So after 3 months, I call the team and I call my manager and I call my vice president. Okay, tell me what you learned from last three months. So they given like, okay, this in this area I'm very poor, this I improved. And this business knowledge, I don't have that, and this. And the people when they're reporting the work, they are 99% they're confusing whether it is a defect, whether it is or not, like that. So I given like confidence, they gain the confidence by failing this.
Two minds working together. Very tricky. Two creative and advanced minds working together is the task.
And the people are scared to talk with Anse.
Maybe like our one beginner, one expert. That will work out very
well. Yeah,
that's true. Beginners will pick up very fast.
That is how the whole project is going. Not one, two. 9 plus 1 is what there, right?
Yes.
We run in that same way.
Correct.
Otherwise, billing will not work for us.
That's true.
And you can apply this on the shadow resources, like from the college they come and train them, right?
Interns.
So they'll be in shadow.
Right.
Let them work, pay them, and even they'll be very much productive very soon.
But then their inputs as a same way to review, the idea was that they skip a few reiteration steps. That won't be happening because that guy is a learner.
Yes.
So he may not be able to review a senior's test code or review.
No, that
test
can't review.
Right?
That
but you can pair that way so that he'll reach some level.
Sure. Initially, yes, but over the
iterations.
All right. Yeah. I think. Thank you.
So thank you. Big round of applause for thanks, Rama. I think very practically, if you see in our Bangalore traffic, if I can take this example, whenever the traffic cops are there, they are in pairs. Have you noticed that?
Mm.
Yeah.
Right? One guy, the pilot will be sitting on the bike or in the car, the other guy will be taking the keys and sending it to him. It works really well. And especially when there is a small board which tells there is no U-turn, we usually doesn't notice and we take it. Or when there is a place where there's a new signal that is established.
And we didn't realize it.
And we don't. Sometimes we realize but we try to jump. if
So the session also pilot cooperated too with the plan.
Absolutely. So that's what we're trying to demo here as well. So some of these things, you know, which we have discussed, I think some of them we have covered already. As I said, you know, we require a certain time. Though it's time saving, we require a certain time. We need to practice it and we need to adapt and embrace it as well. Otherwise, it's very, very tough. And it could be both, Anu, as you rightly mentioned, or other question, it could be bottom up. Or top down as well.
Okay.
So, but usually it has to start with top down because we need to get a commitment because we need to tell the sponsor, boss, give me some time, as Prabhakaran mentioned. You know, we will give you certain results, but give us some time. Right? Then social inclination, it's very important. This both has to go together. We cannot put two different people who doesn't really go well and we cannot expect the results. Right? A lot of soft skills comes into the picture here. So teamwork, very important, and of course something which cannot be measured, can never be controlled, as rightly said. So we cannot start measuring it right from the day one, but we need to wait certain time because the way we are trying to pair is one experience and maybe one non-experience or maybe shadow resource with an expert and so on and so forth. So it takes some time, you know, for this to really go and showcase the results. So this is what the conclusion, some of the things, you know, because of Prabhakar and Rama we already covered. It's not a magic, just we do this one and then we have the pair testing or pairing really working across the different software development or the product engineering lifecycle, right? It takes some time. And then it is another technique. So somebody, one of our colleagues said that how different is it from the extreme programming, right? It's a similar one, you know, it's a similar adaptation that has been done from there and, you know, we are trying to implement it for testing. And we can scale it up at a later point of time as well, right? But we have to start somewhere. That's the whole point. Then, this already we discussed and some of us has experiences. So dev test, testing program manager, etc. These strengths come together. Then we have to really use it wisely and carefully. So I think I have a last slide part for you, but where it says that, yeah, better than 2 is definitely fine, but what happens if we have more than 2? On a lighter note. Alright, so before I click my button, are there any further questions that me and Rama can help you understand?
How do you generally manage that flexibility? Like, pair programming, we do have unique knowledge between the 2, and then we will obviously have a conflict within the pair.
Correct.
XP is having one of the major disadvantages in that, rather they, so even though go for refactoring, they have a problem of pair programming, which is a major problem is conflict among the individual pairs.
Correct.
So how are you having up a mitigation plan for having up with the same conflict happening in pair this time?
So there are multiple ways, you know. One is the, while before I go to the map, there is your mind. So before I go there, so there are so many things, you know. One is the human factor. Some of the, yeah, I would say the previous these things. So we have to be very careful when we select these pairs. But and after we have human beings, there are more than 2 heads, there are politics, right, coming into picture. And then we need to really bring in awareness, soft skills, and you know, it takes some time for them to
flexibility
really adapt it as well. Venkat, you say something?
No, no. More than 2 people itself is a big trouble for me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, of course.
I'm a coordinator for both of them. Hey, Venkat, you won't talk to Venkat. Every other fellow also won't talk to Venkat. Yeah. I done 5 times all conflict resolution.
Oh, wow.
Didn't work. Okay. I keep one fellow, boss, you go and do with some other thing.
Changing the pairs.
Changing
the pairs.
I moved the resource out.
So even that I don't know, pair testing, you know, this is very prevalent in the educated IT community. Let me put it like this.
Yeah.
Right? Educated IT community.
Can you cite a live example of somebody who's really using this and has come up with some impressive numbers for us?
Results. What results?
Yeah. Do you have a number? Maybe Rama, you can.
I have implemented 3-4 projects.
Okay. Anything?
I paid like EA and testing. And dev and tester.
And how productive is it?
Actually, productivity is more.
How?
Because they don't use any Google things. They don't do their personal things.
Do you have a number
that... See, what I'm trying to say is, from an organization perspective, if you have to position it, like you said, top down, we have to shoot numbers. If you just tell more, he's going to ask how much more. How is it going to affect my bottom line?
They demand you more, right, for the management.
But they have top line and bottom line, right? So you have to position it. I just want to know a workable thing where you have something that you can share with us so that will help us.
I'll share.
So, you can take Anu's mail ID and you probably
yes,
can.
Yes, I'll do.
Share
that.
We'll
get in touch. Yeah.
All right.
So, yeah, earlier also we used the earlier, for that also we do code review, right? Peer to peer review.
Correct.
Already we have this concepts already there earlier.
Yeah.
The same concepts already there. So just to implement for the testing, right?
Correct.
And second question, the automation, right?
Yeah.
We took the words automation, we could not use it.
Right?
We can.
My question is, now automation also we can review it. See, before they want to do the scripting, right? They can review the scripting.
Absolutely.
One person do the scripting, other person
you
can
do
it.
You can pair
the third one, right? Okay, number of test cases also can be reduced.
Yes.
If you do pair, right? Okay. Yeah. You know that, you know, other words, so many concepts. Pair-wise tools also available in the market. You see, in some of the test cases, finite test cases is enough to test the whole thing.
Correct.
The complexity, okay, psychometric complexity will reduce.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
If you use the water, the parameters. Yes.
Sure, thank you. The feedback is very important for us. I think we are doing, after our marriage, we are sharing the stage for the first time.
Wow.
So the feedback is extremely important for us. And we have been implementing it in our life as well, you know. So at least in the life perspective, I can give you some numbers, I would say.
I will.
So thank you so much. And before I go, so I, as I promised, I will.
Yes.
There are 2. You bet. I will just want to say that.
Really? I read your mind.
When you said that, I'll show you the last time. I said 3. You know what 3 means?
3 means, yes, absolutely. So this is only on a lighter note, but nevertheless, hopefully we gave certain message and then we tried to show you certain possibilities that it can be done. And if done, we do have certain results. But it's not a magic, it takes some time. So we need to be patient. We need to have a top down and bottom up as well. And it works. So we have Kalunstrom.
As well, stakeholders buy-ins.
That's what, no? Providing
very, 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 very important.
even the
girl. In your life as well, without your wife's concurrence, what else you can do?
And one more thing, when we got this opportunity to take up this topic, it was very less time, almost 4 or 5 days were there. And when we worked together on this, it was like we didn't even know the time. You know, we were working as a pair in this. So confidence was more.
Absolutely.
That's true. I agree with the concept of pairing, but there are so many
advantages are there, disadvantages are there. But you have to learn.
You have to abide by that before you even reach to the point of implementing it.
The rules have to be defined.
Yes. Yeah, here and here, everywhere.
The game rules have to be set. And then we need to follow it in a disciplined manner.
Yes.
That's very important.
Many.
And we have to program our team members such a way that they all follow that.
That's true. Absolutely.
Rama, would you like to say something on ACP certification?
Yeah, ACP certification, like I'm also a volunteer with the PMI Bangalore chapter, and if anyone is interested, I can mentor you.
I'm already studying for it. I have to give my exam in June.
Some of the concepts, we have a PMI stall there as well where Jacob is sitting. You can get some information, and maybe if you want further information, maybe this is Rama's email ID. We can contact you as well.
Okay.
All right. Sure. Thank you so much.
You said you were working for?
I work for Arman.
H-A-R-M-A-N.
That is an audio company, right?
It is an audio company.
Yeah. Arman. Which company?
I'm with Advanced, UK based company. I'll give my cards.
Yeah, I'll need your cards.
Sure. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thanks.